Hey everyone, today's video is going to cover a fairly neat way to speed up your CFD workload in OpenFOAM for parallel cases. Typically, after running a parallel case in OpenFOAM, I like to reconstruct the case. I find that this makes post-processing much quicker and stable in paraview. It may be surprising, it certainly was for me, but for larger cases, especially with many time steps, this process of reconstruction can be a fairly lengthy calculation. It is definitely not going to take as long as the simulation itself, but it can easily be 1 to 2 hours long. So to make a fairly long story short, I had a large simulation that I wanted to reconstruct for post-processing, and after a few hours looking through the forums and the like, I found this super cool script. The basic premise of this script is that the reconstructPar function is a serial process. Thus, the process could be drastically sped up if reconstructPar could be run in parallel. A simple way to do this, and how it is implemented in this script, is to split the time steps into even sets for each core, and then run reconstructPar simultaneously on each core. Let's imagine we just ran a simulation on 2 cores and saved 4 time steps. Your case directory should look something like this. Now if we run reconstructPar, it will reconstruct in the following serial fashion. With reconstructPar parallel, we could run on 2 cores, and we could run it on 4 cores. Before we get a bit deeper into the discussion of this code and see the improvements it gives, let me show you how you would use it for one of your simulations. The first step is to download the file and have it in your case directory. Next, we need to change the permission of the file system objects to allow us to execute the script. This is done with the following command. Now we can just run the simulation as we normally would. And finally, once we have our results, we will execute the script with the following syntax, where the number refers to the number of processes you want to run in parallel. Just as a bit of a demonstration, I will now pull up the results in paraview. You can see that when I am switching between time steps of the reconstructed case, it is definitely a bit faster than for the decomposed case. It is not so noticeable for this file because it is a fairly small 2D case, but for larger cases, the disparity becomes more and more apparent. Here are the results from some larger simulations I ran and timed how long the reconstruction process took. Please note that on the y-axis I am plotting how many times faster it was to reconstruct than an identical case on 1 core. It is interesting to note that the process run on 2 cores was around twice as fast, but we did see some diminishing returns after that. I would likely attribute this to the limitations in memory speed of my system. Another interesting trend to note is the relatively better performance for the higher count processes when there were more overall time steps. This may be due to recovering some of the lost time from initializing and parallelizing the function by having more percentage of the time actually running the more efficient parallel algorithm. The final thing I want to discuss is the classification of this as real or pseudo-parallel. The authors of this script classify as pseudo-parallel, but after some digging, I am left a bit confused why. Here are some definitions I pulled from Object-Oriented Systems Analysis and Design, Chapter 6, Advanced Topics. The link to this will be in the description down below. Real parallelism consists of the parallel modes of physical devices so that each can carry parallel operations to each other. Core parallelism consists of real parallelism, multiple core processes which are physically different and perform their own operations in parallel. Pseudo-parallelism consists of the same device carrying the parallel operation. We can logically manage the parallelism for system. Concurrent processing using parallelism is the pseudo-parallelism which operates either in time division or using other types of parallel algorithms. I would need to really look at the nuts and bolts of the script, but it seems like the script executes an n number of reconstruct pars in parallel, which would be real parallelism, although with no memory sharing or data transfer between cores. But I am not fully sure. Maybe it is using concurrent processing or some other pseudo-parallel mode. I'm leaving this as a bit of an open question that I would love to see being discussed in the comments down below. I'm not some fountainhead of knowledge. I have and continue to learn a bunch from all of you in the comments. The comment sections have been great, so let's keep up the discourse. Great, I hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful. Hopefully it will save you a lot of time and headache with your post-processing. If you did like it, please give the video a thumbs up, comment, and share it. Have a good one, goodbye.